class today, we learned about we learned about what is proportion for the equation. First of all, we have learned about the relationship between ratios and proportions. And we would like to write the proportions. Okay? So, okay, this one is 70 gram equal over 10 beans. Okay? And also, as for the same one, also 51 gram over 20 beans. Regina, please wake up. What are you doing last night? Why you were sleeping? Okay, can you ask my question? What is this? 70 gram over? You don't know. That's why I tell you, you have to concentrate in your class, okay? Okay, okay, Zira, can you tell again? 70 gram over? 10 beans, okay? It says if 10 beans have mass of 71 gram, then the 30 beans have mass of 51 gram. So this is the solution, okay? Alright, so after this, I will give you exercise. So do exercise at page 85.
Didn't pass your maths. I have seen your previous report that your maths is one of your problems. Okay. After this, I will call you and ask her for a permission. Okay? Go back to us.
Yes, Kami.
Both have problems. One of them have both problems with behavior. Means that she is always sleeping in class. Her name is Regina.
About another one, she has a very low grade in maths course, and she didn't understand, like, not I really understand, like, he said that, she said that it's, the calculation is really...
really hard for her to understand the mathematics that you talk to her.
Yes.
So...
So, do we, after this, I thought that, do we have to make a meeting for the parents?
We must have a meeting with the PDS to make, to hear what the parents want to say about their student and about their children, and also what they don't know about what their student, their children mean in the class. So we must have the PDS meeting as soon as possible to make this
okay.
We can solve this problem together with their parents.
Alright. Okay, if that's the case, then I will call the parents.
Yes.
Alright. Okay, that's all. Thank you. Because we also can discuss about your child's problem and how to solve it. Because I heard that she said that mathematics is quite confusing to her. And I hope you can come to the meeting.
Okay. Tell Emmet, if I have a time, I come and see you, okay?
Alright.
Thank you for coming, teacher.
Alright.
Okay.
I hope you can come to the meeting.
Okay.
Thank you. And I will call my
call. All right.
Good morning to everyone. I am
Regina mother. I want to say sorry about my child behavior in class. Yes, as parent, I want my child success in her study. However, I'm a working mother. I don't have time to ask her about what's going on in her school or study. And I also don't want to push my child. So I just let she do whatever he want at home. Because I believe at school, she do well in her class. So here, I really hope teacher can help me to change my children behavior. After this, I will try to spend my time with my child, and I hope teacher is open to give me any information that I need about my child. That's all.
As for your question, I as a teacher also really concerned about this and hope that we can all find a solution for the problems. And also as a working, I also a working parent also as a teacher. You also as a working parent also. And then yes, we might be not able to track our child's progress on her homework. However, we do have apps called Students Homework Tracking. It is an app that can track your child's you know what your child's doing, and you can also remind her about she is have homework and remind her not playing too much your games. And also we hope that with these apps we can update to you about your child's progress and also about your child's homework. Then you can invite her and get her alert on her studies. Okay, that's all.
Okay, thank you, teacher.
Next is from Zura.
You said to your teacher that you don't understand anything that she taught you. So, as a parent, have you ever asked her about progress in school?
In my opinion, I will depends to the school how to give the good facilities to their students, because I still support. What is important is that to improve students' performance or achievement in the subject, not only subject, but on all the subject. As a parent, I really want the best for them in their studies.
In my opinion, teacher in this school, especially a math teacher, should do a workshop for the students. As we know, many students don't like math step. So through this workshop, teacher can make students more interested.
That's a very good suggestion. We hope that we will implement this workshop, mathematics workshop, in the future. And we hope that other parents also will agree with the suggestion. So, any more things you want to add?
Good morning, teacher. In my opinion, my suggestion to the school is to provide more variety classroom assessment, because according to my child, according to my daughter, the teacher only provide talk and chalk teaching classroom, which is make her not interested in mathematics subject. So I hope the teacher can consider my suggestion.
Alright. So I also want to add something. Okay. In
students, and we want them to become more more with the learning technology, blended learning technology. So there is a various way of technology we can use. Okay, as a for children who likes games or something, maybe they can play a game-based learning, which is, we call it as a Kahoot. We always implement it in the class, but maybe we want to improve it more and make it more interesting. So I hope that if we have a budget, we would like all of the mathematics or science street class, we would like to do it so. We would like to have this game-based learning so that their learning become more interesting and make their learning, make a fun learning activity for them. So if you have any suggestion more, you can add up anything.
Is there any suggestion from the parent side? So here, I am the principal. This is my suggestion. Make media safe competition, where students have to compete each other in order to get the reward. As we know, students love reward rather than punishment. So we as teacher and parents will have to proceed to our reward giving to the student to achieve and did not give direct punish to the student if they get wrong. As we know, students will go rebel and make some more discipline problem for us during that. That's also for me. Okay, that's all for our meeting for today. Thank you for the cooperation and give your ears and time to us.
Okay, before we end our, we like to explain the scenes for our each of us. Actually, we have 5 scenes in total, and for the first scene is the P&L session, which is during the teaching and learning lecture session. The both of these students, they met some, create some problems. One of them sleep in the class, and one of them, they has problems in the day. As for second scene, we call one of the students to come in front and tell us about their problems, and also explain to them if the consequences about them being like that, if they make the problem worse. As for scene 3, the teacher will meet the principal in order to help a meeting that will solve both of the problems, not just solve the problems, but create new ideas that can make an interest of a subject that we just now tell about is about mathematics. And for the fourth scene, we call the parents, because in order to call, we make the parents not upset during the meeting, we call them first because communication is very important. That was first. And then for the fifth scene is a PTA meeting, PTA association meeting. So we held PTA meeting together with the parents. So both of them have become parents. And we hope that you enjoy our role play. So thank you.